That's Larry Coryell in the Seventh House, his last recorded album. I miss him. I'm using short painter's tape cuts so I can follow the curve of the guitar's body as I tape it just below the top. So when I stain it, it's not going to get over the edge of the top wood piece. And that way, when I finish staining it, I will be able to stain the sides and the back a different color if I want. And I think I'm thinking of tobacco brown or red mahogany for the side and back. I'm going to try and do a green blue burst, which will be the blue and green theme that I'm trying to do in honor of Miles Davis's album. And hopefully this will turn out to be a good jazz guitar. Who knows? But it's fun. I don't know, I'm not very happy with this 3M painter's tape, because while it delivers a very good edge, it does leave some residue behind, which I'm a bit concerned about, but nothing that a little bit of rubbing alcohol can get off the wood. You just have to make sure you let the wood dry out before you attempt to stain it after removing the tape. Otherwise, you have the last one in hand with alcohol coming out the thing that you apply. You try to clean the masking tape glue off the sides. Alright, almost done taping. Hard on the curves because the paint and the masking tape keeps on wrinkling, and you have to have a clean edge, no wrinkles, especially at the border where you want to stain the end. Okay, done. Take a look. So, stain goes on top and on the edges, but not on the sides, which is why I've applied the masking tape. And I'm going to take all the wrinkles out by just pressing. That's the good part about this masking tape. When you press hard enough, the air bubbles tend to go out and it collapses in, creating a very thin ridge that doesn't allow the paint to permeate in. The thing is, at this edge, there should be no air gaps, so the paint or the stain will dribble down onto the sides. Alright. Let's see. Now, I'm using Keda Dye stain powder from Wisconsin. Found it on Amazon, and it has a whole flowchart of how to go about doing this staining job. The good thing about this dye is it shows different colors. So there's yellow. Well, let me just change the order in which they've shown it here. So we turn red here, yellow, blue, brown, and black. And all you do is add water or alcohol. I'm just going to use water just so I don't have the fumes, because I'm doing this in my basement. And it should be pretty easy. I do need an additional container so I can mix two or three different colors from the base colors to arrive at the green that I want. And the blue should be pretty much the blue that's here. So it shows right here, let me just bring it up. Blue plus red is purple, red plus yellow is orange, blue plus yellow is green. So I will need to mix these two and then blue alone to be able to get my green and the blue burst. So green is going to be probably a teardrop shape like this, okay? And then the blue burst will go all on the edges with a fading in, using a sock that I'll dip in and kind of spread the stain, okay? So, it's hard to read, it's so small. I wish they gave a larger print so you could like stick it on the wall and look at it. Okay, prepare the wood, that's done. Proper wood sanding will provide best results for our wood stain. I did a really fine sandpaper polishing of the entire top, sides and back, and the neck, and the headstock, sides, top and back. So the guitar is ready for staining. It's incredibly smooth. I used, I believe, like very, very fine sandpaper. I can show you which one I used. I used 800, P800 3M pre-cut. Got it as Tumac as part of a kit. And it does a pretty decent job. So, let's see. The other thing is, I saved some cotton from somewhere, I don't know where the heck I got this, but I can use it to dab when I start fading in the blue burst after doing the green. So, might as start with yellow and then add blue in little bits to the yellow. By the way, this dye is plant-based. Completely safe, non-toxic. I hope it's washable, I don't know, but just in case it's not, I'm gonna say it's aniline dye. I have no idea what that is, but so I got some gloves at Home Depot, latex gloves. Can you do them? Just in case the paint decides to stain my skin or my nails, which would be bad. This will prevent any paint from getting on me. So now I'm going to try and mix a little bit of yellow. Let's see. Start with a very small amount. Do not spill it over the guitar. You'll be in trouble. As a matter of fact, I need to move these poles in front so I don't mess up anything as I'm working on the guitar. Let's do that right now. I'll give myself interference so I don't screw anything accidentally. But And also, have a cloth handy, so if there's any drips or anything, you can dab it, pick it up quickly, and wipe it clean. The guitar kit came in these styrofoam sheets that it was packed in, the body and the neck. And so I kept it. It's a good idea to do that because when you're staining, there might be some drops that splatter. And when they splatter, the styrofoam is disposable, it can catch it. So at least I prefer to do it that way. Alright, so we've got some yellow here. I'm going to add a little bit of water and see how that thing behaves. Wow. Don't know if you can see it, but it's quite awesome. Here we go. Can you see it? Yellow. Now, I need to wipe the paint. So when I use the same spoon to get to the blue dye to arrive at my green, I don't put yellow water into the blue dye pack. It's important to be extremely careful not to spill any specks of dry powder paint or dye anywhere else than where you intend to use it, because it's going to be an immediate problem. Alright, so I'm putting some blue in here and boom, specks all over. Take my own advice and seal the top. Now, building up really nice dark green. You can see it. Okay. So what will happen is, as I start to stain this green along the middle in a teardrop, I'll start in the center and then go outward gradually, and then leave a faded dabbing at the end with old polo socks. Okay, so here we go. I hope this works. If not, I am so dead. Let's see. Okay, so as I clean the spoon, I can actually get a good sense of the color that's going to appear on the guitar. I have to stir it really well so that the yellow and the green blend in, because there's a lot of tonality here. But I can work with that, it's not a big problem. Alright, before I start staining, let's see what else this guy says. Proper wood sanding, yada da. Wet the wood with hot water. Huh? Okay. Our first dye stain coat for deeper look. Wipe off excess, let dry completely. Sand thoroughly using 150-180 grit sandpaper. Higher grits may reduce penetration. Optional, clean with mineral spirits or alcohol and allow to dry if desired. Wipe all dust particles off, I've done that. With a lint-free towel. Use a wood conditioner or wood sanding sealer. Also maybe use yada. Okay, powder base with water. Start with warm water. Ratio 8 ounces of mixed stain will cover 16 square feet. I think I have enough here. Slowly add the dye while still stirring. Continue stirring until dyes thoroughly mixed. Let mixture rest for 30 minutes. Stir well. Check to ensure that all dyes are dissolved for best results. Water-based version only. It's still not fully dissolved. Heat in microwave. No, I'm not doing that. Because it can kind of splatter and the microwave just gets stained, and then guess what? We have the wipe to deal with. Clean the dye stain solution if needed. No, not needed. Alright, so we'll let this sit for 30 minutes. I think it looks pretty even though. What do you think? Oh, there's some specks. You can see the specks in there. Let me add some water to thin this out so I can actually work with the dye by coating it multiple times. There we go. I think you're in good shape. We will let it sit for 30 minutes and resume.